good evening. So good to have you here as we bring our Lenten journey to a close. As tonight we talk about kind of all of it. And we say, open my life, Lord. So good to have you here. Those joining us online, a special welcome to you. Just want to bring your attention to Holy Week as we begin that on Sunday. We start with our Palm Sunday celebration, and then we have Monday, Thursday, Good Friday, and then our Easter Sunday. So all of that information has been in bulletins, is on Facebook, so I invite you to be a part of that. Our Good Friday service is out at Ottawa. And so any of you that worship here at Sundahl on a regular basis, you don't want to make the drive yourself, please talk to myself, talk to Janice. We will find somebody to pick you up and bring you out. I want as many of us together for our Good Friday celebration as possible. And that goes also for our sunrise service on Easter Sunday. I think that's all I have. I invite you to stand as we begin with our opening dialogue.
When our lives are joyous and laughter abounds,
Christ is dwelling there.
When the news is grim and we have nowhere to turn,
Christ is dwelling there.
In the water and the word, the bread and the wine, in our life, in our death, in the new life to come,
Christ is
loving. Together we sing number 744. Bore the cross and who dwells in us, be with you all.
Also with you.
Let us pray. Open our minds, Lord, to reflect your glory. Lead us to the cross, to the grave, to the empty tomb, and into the world as imitators of Christ. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
You may be seated.
This reading comes from Deuteronomy 30, verses verses 15 through 20. See, I have set before you today life and prosperity, death and adversity. If you obey the commandments of the Lord your God that I am commanding you today, by loving the Lord your God, walking in his ways, and observing his commandments, decrees, and ordinances, then you shall live and become numerous, and the Lord your God will bless you in the land that you are entering to possess. But if your heart turns away and you do not hear, but are led astray to bow down to other gods and serve them, I declare to you today that you shall perish. You shall not live long in the land that you are crossing the Jordan to enter and possess. I call heaven and earth to witness against you today that I set before you life and death, blessings and curses. Choose life so that you and your descendants may live, loving the Lord your God, obeying him, and holding fast to him. For that means life to you and length of days, so that you may live in the land that the Lord swore to give to your ancestors, to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob. This is from Psalm 16. Protect me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, you are my Lord. I have no good apart from you. As for the holy ones in the land, they are the noble, in whom is all my delight. Those who choose another god multiply their sorrows. Their drink offerings of blood I will not pour out or take their names upon my lips. The Lord is my chosen portion of my cup. You hold my law. The boundary lines have fallen for me in pleasant places. I have a goodly heritage. I bless the Lord who gives me counsel. In the night also my heart instructs me. I keep the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand. I shall not be moved. Therefore, my heart is glad, and my soul rejoices. My body also rests secure. For you do not give me up to souls, or let your faithful one see the pit. You show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. In your right hand are pleasures forevermore.
A reading from the second chapter of Galatians. We ourselves are Jews by birth and not Gentile sinners. Yet we know that a person is justified not by works of the law, but through faith in Jesus Christ. And we have come to believe in Christ Jesus so that we might be justified by faith in Christ and not by doing the works of the law, because no one will be justified by works of the law. But if, in our effort to be justified in Christ, we ourselves have been found to be sinners, and is Christ then a servant of sin? Certainly not. But if I build up again the very things that I once tore down, then I demonstrate that I am a transgressor. For though the law, I died to the law, so that I might live to God. I have been crucified with Christ, and it is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith as the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. I do not nullify the grace of God, for it is justification comes through the law. Then Christ died for nothing. Well, dear friends in Christ, grace and peace to you from God our Father, and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So here we are. We are at the end of this Lenten journey. A journey that has brought us to open our eyes, to see around us what God has given, to see around us what matters most. How does our perspective change when we view the world through the eyes of Christ? How do we see each other through those eyes? And we're told to open our hands. Hands that can do so many things. We can pick up a child, serve a meal, play an instrument, wipe a tear away. See, Jesus uses his hands to heal. So then we ask ourselves, how can we use our hands in this kingdom? How can we use our hands as we think of all the sacrifices that Jesus did for us? Maybe that's what it is, wiping a tear away. Picking up our Bible to read. Or using them to simply hug someone close to us. And then we open our ears. Probably the easiest one to do, right? We open our ears, we hear God's word, we hear the music. Not only of things in our own life, but as we journey towards that cross of Calvary, we hear Christ. We hear him on that cross. Jesus reminds us that we sometimes hear, we don't always listen. Sometimes we listen, but we don't really hear, right? Opening our ears isn't just as easy as it simply sounds. Let me focus on our heart. What does our heart tell us to do? When it comes to our faith, it tells us to follow Christ. It tells us to love, to cherish. And it all comes down to this, to now, to opening our lives. Open my life, Lord, it says. Open my life to your saving grace. Open my life to this cross of Calvary. Open my life so that I can hear you. That I can reach out to you. I can see you. It's in his promise to us as he comes to this cross that we have eternal life. That everything he does is for us. That our life is promised to eternity. That our life is promised through the grace of God. Not by the works that we do, but through faith in Jesus. Paul tells us in this passage of Colossians that we have died to the law so that we might live to God. Right? That it is no longer we who live, but Christ who lives in us. And that's what our Lent journey is about. It's about following Christ to that cross, about remembering in us the sacrifice. How we open ourselves to him, to his love. much as we want to look to that Easter cross, we have to focus on the cross of Calvary. We have to focus on the Good Friday cross. Because without that, we don't have an Easter story. We don't have an Easter resurrection. That Good Friday cross, the cross of Calvary, gives us freedom. Freedom to open our eyes and our hands and our ears and our hearts to a life of blessing, to a life of understanding, to a life of forgiveness. God didn't say that everything was going to be easy. He said he was always going to be there, right?
Yeah.
So we take that, this Lent. Probably now more than ever, like we talked about on Sunday, we need Holy Week. We need to remember now more than ever in these times of uncertainty, at times of confusion, sadness, that Christ is with us, that Christ went to this cross for us, and that he loves us unconditionally. And it is in that love that we share with each other as we journey together, as our faith strengthens, as our love for one another grows, and as we can come together and say, open my life, Lord, to you. Open my life to your eternal kingdom, and to that glorious resurrection. That we live by the faith Son of God.
Hi.
That we live in Christ, for Christ, and that we take this journey with him. As we lay it at the foot of the cross, as we see him on that cross, we know that we have life eternal. We know that we can celebrate that resurrection cross once again. God has walked with us. Jesus has been with us in this journey. Let him continue to be in your hearts. Listen for him with your ears. Reach to him through your Holy Scripture. See him as your Lord and Savior. Thanks be to God. Amen. Sing together, number 500. invite you to stand as together we share in the prayer. Lord of all life, when we cannot see the beauty of your creation, when we neglect the poor, the sick, and the grieving, when we ignore the cries of injustice in our midst,
open our ears that all will know your love.
When we are hardened against our neighbors,
open our hearts and heal our resentment.
When we are closed to the grace you long to give us,
open our eyes and turn us to follow the way of the cross.
Into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the Lord. Receive the blessing. Go into the world with eyes open to the transforming light of Christ, hands open to serve those you meet, ears open to the call of the Spirit, hearts open to the bountiful love of God, and lives open to follow Christ to the cross. The God who opened for us the way of everlasting life, bless you now and forever. Amen. Together we sing We Are Called, number 720.
Thank you.
peace. Christ is with you.
Amen.